Hey guys, welcome to Inspire Chemistry. Today we have with us Mr. Rish Kalipu, who has been selected for master's program at various universities in the world like Ecole Polytechnique, University of Paris Sud and University of Amsterdam. He was also selected for integrated PhD in ISEP Pune in 2019. We have a separate video of him sharing his experience of the interview, where he talked about how internship could be really handy in the interview or in any selection process. So you can watch this video. The link will be in the description box, so you can just go and check out that. Now Rishabh will be pursuing his master's at Weizmann Institute of Science, Israel, starting from the October. And today he's going to talk about the profits and advantages associated with doing an internship in bachelor's. Over to you, Rishabh. If you are new to our channel, please subscribe and hit the bell icon for receiving latest updates on exams, research positions and guidance videos. So let's start the video.
Hello everyone, my name is Rishabh Kalipu. I am here today to talk to you about the profits of doing an internship during a bachelor's degree. So the fact that you clicked on this video implies that you may have at least thought about this, and most of you might even be considering pursuing such an experience. So I will be giving you a few guidelines and pointers to help you all realize if this is the right thing to do, and also to understand what you stand to gain from this experience. Let's get right into it. When we talk about doing a bachelor's internship, what you have to keep in mind is that not everyone gets such an opportunity, and the people who do are very lucky, and you have to keep this in mind, because you know, only if you're really interested in pursuing research later on, this would be right for you. And I'm sure most of you are. So having this kind of advantage right from the beginning really helps you inculcate that mindset of research, and it will help you in further stages of your career. So when you have that interest, you can combine it and develop your capabilities in order to become better at what you do. Now, some of you may have research facilities in your own university. In that case, I would strongly recommend you all to approach your professors and supervisors and ask them if you can do a project there. Whether it be anything small, doesn't matter. What matters is you have the experience to gain from it. So these days, the global consensus is shifting towards the direction where everyone looks upon a bachelor's internship as something favorable. So the universities in India have also taken upon this initiative, and many of them have started offering internship projects during the summer, winter vacation, and even during mid-semester sometimes, if it all works out, the formalities and logistics. This leads me to my second point, wherein people who do have an experience right from their bachelor's are seen more favorably, for example, when they apply for a master's degree, whether in India or abroad, and even when they go on for their higher studies, because no one can take that experience away from you. It is with you, you've learned something from it, and people do recognize that there is some importance to it. So since it helps your profile, it would put you a notch above the other candidates, and therefore you have a higher chance of being selected in whatever you choose to do later on. Now my third point is that we all study chemistry in classrooms and from our textbooks, and we all give our exams. But when you actually do research, and I say this from my own experience, when you do research yourself, you gain a completely different perspective of chemistry, and this for me at least has been immensely helpful, because it has made me have a holistic view of the subject. So you all can become well-rounded individuals while performing research, because you see the reality of chemistry instead of what you just learn in classrooms. So that being said, there are some circumstances where it may not be appropriate to take up these sorts of experiences. So for example, if you have some sort of glorified or convoluted idea about doing research and you think you can just breeze through it, well, you know, that is not the case, unfortunately. The harsh reality is that not everyone is suited to do research, right? So, you know, sometimes it may help you, like if you get into it and you realize it's not for you. But you have to really think about whether this is the right decision for you. And suppose if you do not want to go into research, it may not be so helpful for you as will be other opportunities. So in spite of that, I'm sure most of you are interested in research, and for that reason you can clearly see that the benefits outweigh the cons, and I would strongly encourage you all to take up these opportunities as and when you find them. So if you have any questions for me, please leave them in the comments below, and I'll do my best to answer them all promptly. Thank you.